Hello students, today we will discuss our exercise 1.4. Before proceeding towards our new exercise, let's discuss successive magnification. So what successive magnification is? The process of visualization and representation of real numbers on the number line through magnifying glass is known as successive magnification. That means successive magnification is a process in which we visualize and represent real numbers through magnifying glass on the number line. Right. So let's move towards our exercise 1.4. Our first question is visualize 3.765 on the number line using successive magnification. So first of all, we observe that 3.765 lies between 3 and 4. We'll divide this portion into 10 equal parts. In the next step, we locate 3.765 between 3.7 and 3.8. Now, to get more accurate visualization of representation, we divide this portion of number line into 10 equal parts and use a magnifying glass to visualize that 3.765 lies between 3.76 and 3.77. Now, to visualize 3.765 still more accurately, we divide the portion between 3.76 and 3.77 into 10 equal parts and locate 3.765. Now see how we will do this on our number line. Now here we have represented 3 and 4 on the number line, and we have divided the distance between 3 and 4 on the number line in equal parts. Now if you'll see that our number is 3.765. So to represent 3.765, after decimal point our first number is 7. Our digit is 7. So this number will lie between 3.7 and 3.8. Now this portion will divide further into 10 equal parts. 3.7, 3.71, 3.72, 3.73, 3.74, 3.75, 3.76, 3.77, 3.78, 3.79, 3.8. Now if we'll see the other digit after the decimal point, after 7 there is 6. So the number will lie between 3.76 and 3.77. Now again this portion we will divide into 10 equal parts, right? This way we'll represent this on the number line, and further dividing this portion into 10 equal parts: 3.76, 3.761, 3.762, 3.763, 3.764, 3.765. This is the number that we want to represent. So we are locating this on the number line here. This is all about this question. Now let's move toward our question number second. In question number second, visualize 4.26 bar on the number line up to 4 decimal places. We have to visualize up to 4 decimal places. So in this, first of all, we observe that 4.2626 lies between 4 and 5. Divide this portion into 10 equal parts. In the next step, we locate 4.2626 between 4.2 and 4.3. To get a more accurate visualization of representation, we divide this portion of number line into 10 equal parts and use a magnifying glass to visualize that 4.2626 lies between 4.26 and 4.27. Now again we will divide this portion into 10 equal parts and use a magnifying glass to visualize that 4.2626 lies between 4.262 and 4.263. Now to visualize 4.2626 still more accurately, we divide the portion between 4.262 and 4.263 into 10 equal parts and locate 4.2626 on the number line. Now let's see how we will locate that on the number line. Now as our number is 4.2626, so obviously this number will lie between 4 and 5. So we represent 4 and 5 on the number line and we divide the distance between 4 and 5 into 10 equal parts. Now if I'll see the first digit after decimal, that is 2. So obviously that number will lie between 4.2 and 4.3. Now again the distance between 4.2 and 4.3 we will divide into equal portion, 10 equal parts. Now 4.2, 4.21, 4.22, 4.23, 4.24, 4.25, 4.26, 4.27, 4.28, 4.29 and 4.3. Then again if I look the second digit after decimal point, that is 4.26, so obviously that number will lie between 4.26 and 4.27. Now again the distance between 4.26 and 4.27 will again divide into 10 equal parts. So 4.26 and 4.27, between the distance between these will divide into 10 equal parts. Now 4.261, 4.262, 4.263, 4.264, 4.265, 4.266, 4.267, 4.268, 4.269 and again 4.27. Now if I'll see other digit after the decimal, that is 4.262. So obviously our number will lie between 4.262 and 4.263, right? So again this portion will divide into 10 equal parts. So 4.262 and 4.263 we are dividing into 10 equal parts. When we will divide, the numbers lie between these are 4.2621, 4.262, 4.2623, 4.2624, 4.2625, 4.2626, and that is the number that we want. So obviously we'll locate that number on the number line. So this way we have completed our exercise. Thank you.